KSOP now has a special news bulletin on convicted Murray Gilmore.
Gary Mark Gilmore, who has said all along he wants to die, has been shot by a firing squad at Utah State Prison outside Salt Lake City. A last-minute appeals court order last night, coming just a few hours before Gilmore's scheduled execution at dawn, delayed the execution for 10 days. But then this morning, in an emergency pre-dawn session, the 10th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals overturned the lower judge's order, and within a few minutes, Utah's Attorney General ordered that Gilmore go before a firing squad without further delay. Then Gilmore was led from his prison cell and placed in a van, and he was dressed in white, we're told, with a coat on, and led away to the execution area at the prison. Understand we have Bob Lazich on the line now. Bob Lazich on the line, can you hear me?
Yes, I can now.
Okay, Bob, can you tell us a little more about Gilmore's execution this morning?
Okay, there are no details. None have been announced. Ken Schulzen, the administrative assistant to the director of corrections here at the Utah State Prison, made the announcement. It was a very curt announcement. The order of the 4th Judicial District of the state of Utah has been carried out. That was it. It came at 7:05 Mountain Time. Gary Gilmore is dead. He got his death wish. This is Robert Lazich at the state prison. We're now expecting the warden, who should be here momentarily, and he will fill us in with the details of the execution as he has promised to do.
Bob, before you get away, can you give us perhaps a scenario? You must have known in advance something of the way that Gilmore would have been executed.
Well, the way it was, as we understand it, the plan was to take Gary Gilmore from the maximum security prison, which is set off from the regular prison by about 3 cyclone fences. He was taken in a van. He was dressed in white clothes and a coat. He was taken to the cannery, which is exactly opposite to the other side of the prison. It's a 1,000-acre prison, so it was a considerable distance. He was taken there. We knew that sandbags had been placed in that cannery some time ago, and that's where he was executed. It was a 5-man firing squad, 4 men with real bullets, 1 with blanks, and there were about 20 to 30 persons who witnessed the execution, 4 of them by invitation of Gilmore. A 5th person invited by Gilmore did not attend. His girlfriend, Nicole Barrett, she was barred from attending by the state hospital where she is a patient. The doctors would not allow her to attend. Those who did were his uncle, Vern D'Amico, his 2 attorneys, and a man who has the book and movie rights to Gilmore's life. He says that he'll have a book out in about 2 years and a movie about the same time. Gilmore had indicated repeatedly that he wanted to die. He was disappointed when the stay was issued last night. He cussed out the judge for issuing it, and he also had bad things to say about the American Civil Liberties Union. Their effort, although valiant toward the end, has failed. Gary Gilmore has been executed, the 45th person to die on death row in Utah history. Most of those have been shot to death. You get the choice of the firing squad or hanging in Utah. Gilmore is the first execution in the United States in almost 10 years, the first in Utah in almost 17 years.
Thank you, Bob. Of course, this is the end of Gilmore's life, but certainly not the end of the Gilmore story. It is certain to be ruminated over by legal people and by the news people, media people, and all Americans for many months to come. Not only the fact that it has more or less reestablished the carrying out of the death penalty, as it has not been for the last 10 years, but also the fact that Gilmore, in saying he wanted to die, raised many, many legal questions. And I'm certain that there are those, many around the country right now, who feel maybe Gilmore really didn't want to die, and it was all an attempt to prevent his execution. We'll never know now. Again, Gary Mark Gilmore, who has said all along he wants to die, has been shot by a firing squad at Utah State Prison outside Salt Lake City.
KSOP now repeats the main story. Gary Gilmore, convicted murderer, has been shot at Utah State Prison. Now back to more music at KSLP.